Yes, so if you've been with me because of my florals, I apologize for today's video, but if you've been following me for a long time, you know that my greatest love are cityscapes. I used to do them a little bit more than florals way back when, especially when I did mixed media. So it's nice to go back into this sometimes. And what I wanted to render here was a cityscape at night. It's one of my life's goals to be able to effectively render a cityscape at night, especially with watercolors. So that's what I practiced. Was I successful? I think I've made some progress. I've discovered a few things which I'm going to talk to you about. So let me zoom in. So I realized while I was doing this that the buildings that are the furthest away should have tiny, tiny lights as opposed to the ones that are more in the foreground, which makes sense. They're far. So the windows that are lit up should be smaller. And I think this one was successful. This one wasn't. The windows are way too big. So unless they're huge windows, which could happen too, whatever. But I need to be mindful of that for this kind of painting. Also, I love the addition of the neon jelly roll pens, because buildings do have signage and ads and stuff like that. So I thought this would be fun to introduce. The one thing that I'm not certain about is how to go about separating the buildings that are the ones that are in the foreground from, you know, the other layers of buildings. I know you're supposed to add some shading and whatnot, which I did here, but I think it's too strong. I need to work on this, and you know, here I could have done more, but I decided to, I didn't want to do too much. I didn't want to, you know, dally on this painting. It was just a morning exercise. It was just a last minute thought. I had this background in my book. Can't remember what it was supposed to be like. Unfortunately, it's green. So also, if you don't like green, sorry about that. But I decided to use it, and I don't regret it. I think I've learned a few things, like I said. The trees I love. I absolutely love the dry brushing. Oh my gosh, that was an aha moment. I love the edges that look frayed. Sorry, way too close now. The edges that are a little bit scuffed up, they remind me of old pictures. And that, again, is from handling the book with too much hand lotion when I bound the book. So it's there, but you know what? It offers a lot of resist, which can be cool. Especially, I think I like the look anyways of this. The trees are fun. That tree though, that's in the foreground, the branches are too big for me, but it does make sense. I just don't like the look of the tree, but it's all right. I also added some neon colors here, neon lines to give the suggestion of moving traffic. And of course they pass behind the trees, because the trees are the stuff that's in the foreground. So I made sure that whatever, you know, wherever lines I went over on the trees, I added some paint on there, probably offline, I can't remember. But yeah, anyways, that's my little adventure this morning. I know it's much different from what you're used to seeing on this channel, and I'm not sure if I mentioned it, but again, I do apologize if you're into florals. That might not be your cup of tea. In that case, then you just skip over that one. But I think it's fun to do something that is out of your usual style, something like a subject that is different, because we learn from anything that we do. And so that's how I see it. I happen to love cityscapes, and that's not an issue. But even if you don't like it, and maybe you don't want to do a cityscape, try to do something that's more geometric in terms of subject, as opposed to flowers, which are usually like more, you know, more fluid. They're what's it called? Organic shapes. A building is quite different. more structural is what I want to say. So have a go at it if you're interested, and if you did, you can share your photos with me. I'd love to see them. And as usual, the list of supplies will be in the description below. Oh, I use my Mission Goal Mijello for this. But the supplies will be listed below. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for my awesome patrons who make this possible. Without them, I wouldn't be able to do this free content here on YouTube. And I will see you tomorrow. Bye. Probably with florals again. I don't know. I'm not sure.